If you want to support me on Patreon, feel free to do so. There are rewards that come with the contribution that you give to me on the site. More details are in the description. Thank you for tuning in.
You really want to talk to him about it, don't you?
Yes! I have to! It's driving me insane with how many people are requesting this!
I don't know if he'll be up to discuss this. He's a very busy man, and the topic gets tiring.
Fuck it. I'm taking the chance.
Hello?
Hey, dude. You know what I'm calling for. We cannot leave this topic in the dust.
Man. Alright, fine. Let's do it.
Crash Team Racing, arguably the best kart racer by many people, has been heavily requested to get remade not only after the Insane Trilogy released, but even prior to it hitting shelves. Today, and very briefly, me and that guy Cal will be giving our two cents on the matter in the simplest manner possibly. If you do want Crash Team Racing to get remade, by all means, more power to you, but this is our opinion. It's 2017, I shouldn't have to state this is our opinion shit anymore. Let's get on with it. So, Naughty Dog made Crash Team Racing. Everyone loved it. Vicarious Visions made Crash Nitro Kart. People loved it, but people also thought it tried too hard to be like CTR, and it didn't play that well, according to the general consensus of the Crash community, which is what made them dislike it. People don't like the Insane Trilogy in comparison to the originals, but that's fine, because Vicarious Visions is a Naughty Dog. They can't make everything exactly the same as the original, especially when the source code isn't provided by the original developer for assistance, but no one can respect that these days. The Insane Trilogy just released, and Vicarious Visions have moved on to work on another project. It is unclear if they will be the only developer for Crash's future. Yes, they are a good candidate, but we don't know if they're down to actually remake the infamous kart racer. However, I will mention briefly that Toys for Bob did assist with the Insane Trilogy, so there might be a chance that we'll get a new game or new kart racer by them. But minus the Toys for Bob thing, this comes back to my point. If Vicarious Visions essentially made Crash Team Racing for PlayStation 4, it would be their actual take on trying to make Crash Team Racing, but on PS4. What this means is that they are at a huge risk of backlash if the game is not as good as the original. They tried that with Crash Nitro Kart. The Crash Insane Trilogy was marketed as a product that focused on aesthetic, so it's likely that they'll get that done in the same way. With the Crash Team Racing remaster. Now, is this to say that they'll purposely make the controls shitty? No. But what this is saying is that you can't be surprised when the visuals have more of an enjoyment compared to how it plays, like the Insane Trilogy. Now, whether you think the controls are bad in Crash Nitro Kart or the controls are bad in the Insane Trilogy, it's really based off of interpretation. Nothing is fact. These developers do these things to experiment and see how it feels, based off of the consumers' feedback to improve on future installments. This just goes for general gaming, period.
But of course, that all depends on how the game is even introduced to the platform. As of now, there are two options: a total remake from the ground up, or a simple upscaled remaster. Now, I know it may sound ridiculous, but the new PS4 firmware update, which is version 5.0, could possibly introduce many new things. One of those is the possible introduction of a PS1 on PS4 feature. With this new implementation, consumers would be able to play Crash Team Racing on their PS4 upscaled to 1080p. But keep in mind, while this is the easier, more practical solution, it comes with a major drawback. Crash Team Racing on the PS1 doesn't support online play, and as such, neither would a simple PS4 remaster. Granted, there are many ways Sony could implement a netplay feature into the game, which is definitely possible, as it can be done on various PC emulators. The big question is, would Sony do such a thing? Jack X, a PlayStation 2 title that actually supported online multiplayer, will be ported to the PS4 later this year. However, though its original release did indeed support online functionality, this port will not. If a PS2 game that allowed 6 players to go head-to-head online won't be able to do the same on its PS4 port, chances are a PS1 game that never had online capabilities at all won't be able to do it either. All of that being said, this is assuming that such a thing as Crash Team Racing being put on the PS4 will even happen at all. As of now, it's way too soon for it to even happen, and with the influx of requests and speculation regarding a possible revival of Spyro, the stakes would be even higher on Vicarious Visions' part. Simply put, they were responsible for the Insane trilogy, and its success has left people with a hankering for Spyro and Crash Team Racing. With such great expectations, even the simplest of flaws is sure to sour the game in the eyes of some, and even outright turn them off to it entirely. We witnessed this happen firsthand with the Insane trilogy. People flipped out when the early builds of levels were missing the most minor of details, or simply didn't look exactly how the fans were hoping them to. Imagine what would happen to Crash Team Racing if it came to the PS4 and the controls were slightly off, or a few of the mechanics were somehow made wonky. It wouldn't turn out very good. Then again, that's just the worst case scenario. The game could turn out fine, but at this point in time, these are factors that need to be considered.
You could create something new, but as long as it doesn't take away the essence or the consistency the Crash Bandicoot series always had, it's not going to be bad. And personally, I feel as though if Vicarious Visions or any other developer remade Crash Team Racing, it wouldn't be bad necessarily, but they would be limiting themselves with resources when they could be doing more things, and whether that's better is simply up to interpretation. Again, I repeat that. A great example of this is the canceled Crash Team Racing 2010 game. We all saw how unique that was going to be before it got changed into a DreamWorks kart racer, and people loved it. I feel like most people, or a lot of people, or everyone in the Crash community is either indecisive on what they want, or are in fear that if the Crash series were to do something different, they'd automatically assume that the series has been killed. But my question is, how do you guys expect the series, or any series for that matter, to progress when it keeps repeating history just with a new coat of paint? It's a lot more than just aesthetic, and I think a lot of people don't understand that. And I will say this, me and Cal have discussed about this personally, and we both think that CTR doesn't need to be remade, but it would be cool. We're not against it, but we don't think that it is a necessity. The only problem is that it'll create more discrepancies within the series, because people are going to want the next game remastered after the other, and we can't keep having that, otherwise the Crash series is just going to be viewed as something that's milked, along with other series that have been milked, and it's going to make the Crash Bandicoot fan base look like hypocrites, because they used to say the same thing for Skylanders and Call of Duty. Just know that devs want to do more than the same shit all the time. It's not them ruining your childhood or ruining your experience, it's them trying out new things. Games are experiments, and that's all I can say. And with that being said, we are finished.
I'm actually really glad we talked about that shit. I'm hoping a lot of people will understand. It's not gonna happen, dude. You saw what happened to Jeremiah's Spyro video. Same thing could happen to this one.
Well, he doesn't really care. I'm sure he'll be fine.